Welcome to BIM Originals, a series aimed at answering some of the most burning questions around BIM. In this video, we will talk about how BIM was used in the construction of the world's tallest statue, the Statue of Unity. So buckle up and let's learn something insightful today.
31st October 2018 marked the inauguration of arguably the most iconic structure of modern-day infrastructure, a structure that highlights the sheer genius of individuals in the AEC industry. Any guesses what we are talking about? We are talking about the Statue of Unity, the world's tallest statue with a height of 182 meters, located in the state of Gujarat, India. Well, let us help you visualize just how tall the structure is. The statue that comes second is the Spring Temple Buddha in China, standing at 128 meters. That's a huge gap. But why are we telling you about it? Because it is directly related to the title of our video. Trust us. The Statue of Unity is a great case study to understand how civil and structural engineers proficient in BIM are getting greater recognition and better career opportunities.
When we talk about Statue of Unity, like I said, it's one of the most important project in the last few years for our country. It was a project of national importance. A lot of many engineers, a lot of many architects, a lot of many specialists came together on board to make it a success. It was not possible by only one team's effort. And there has been variations of BIM across the project which made sure that the timelines were met, which made sure that the quality of the outcome which you see right now standing there tall is achieved, and all of the results are directly and indirectly being impacted by BIM adoption altogether in different stages of the construction. This kind of structure was a bit of a complex scenario because it was not a regular form of building. So you have to make sure that you're using the right plugins, the right tools to do it. So that was essential. And I think the 3D modelers did a great job. We did a build, the overall building was built in LOD 300 to 350. And the intent was to make sure that we do all the next levels of things, which is simulations in terms of safety planning, logistics planning, also taking care of construction sequencing, because that was very important in this type of projects. These are like not typical projects. And once we move on to the modeling part, the next part which was also covered in the form of BIM implementation on the project was basically 4D sequencing. Now, when we talk about building of statues, there's also contextual data available, like the geography is not so very common. It's not a barren land. We are actually dealing on the banks of a river and there's a dam associated to it. So we have to make sure that the sequencing is in such a manner that there is no risk and calamities happening in the future. So to make sure that each of the sequences for the are synced with the schedules, the schedule optimization could be done correctly and the timeline could be matched, 4D applications are used like Synchro and Navisworks, where we make sure that the sequencing was simulated as shown to the project managers and executives. Coming up to all of those things, I think the opportunities for BIM, especially for engineers, are immense. There's a lot to be done on engineering and construction front. I think there are different sectors which all of this could be catered and taken care of by adoption of BIM or digital tools. So I think we should be talking about this much more often and try to understand how we can disrupt the industry altogether as an engineer.
Hope you found this video insightful. Make sure to check out our other videos from BIM Originals, and don't forget to subscribe to Novator.